Like it. Ready for Ludicrous Speed Roll. These enemies have a life grip. shrapnel off you. What does 3X miss? Next song. That works. Meteor and Cyclonic. Wow, those are all strong abilities. Giggy. Wow. Do they break? They don't break. That's wow. Okay, well that's interesting. Well, we have party-wide healing now. We just have to use the repair paradigm. And we have access to it too. Fighting Rhoda. Holy shit, Chaos has joined the team. This is incredible. We have the original and most powerful fiend of all. Are naked terrorists.
And his name is John C.
Chaos has evil too. That's amazing. And Chaos has sacrificed himself to heal. What the hell is going on here? We can't provide. Thank you. one comes dice. That's amazing. Strongest moves I've seen. So wait, do we auto revive after that? What happens here? We do auto revive, wow. Actually a pretty good sprite for Kale. I think the percentage appears to be some type of remainder for your next level up, which is kind of helpful. I'm gonna take some encounters here. I'm sitting back a bit. I'll move forward. Should be better now. Well, as long as we don't run into that thing again, we'll be okay. Thank you. Isn't that still too low? Okay, we'll bring SNES down by a quarter. Appreciate you giving me your earsy. Now there's some names for you. Hey, oh, it's you. It's Chaos. Proceed. We're definitely going to have to do a grind here. Also, this air lancer does something different than it normally does. That's what the question mark means if it's next to the island. Effect Atma. So does that mean it's HP-based damage? It's way stronger than what we have, so we're taking it. Hey, I know the song. So these guys absorb wind damage. Okay, we can use Noise Blaster in battle and we get a carbuncle effect. And we get a mute effect from Bio Blaster. Interesting. some nice MP on Stero there. This group here gives us quite a bit as well, so we're actually trying to get this group. Cannot run through this guy. As much gold as I would have liked. Thank you, Sensi, for the contribution. Welcome, Hate Camel. Cat gems are our goal. This debug. Master designer of machinery is the Ant Lion. The Ant Lion is a master of machinery? is quite a bunch we got here. We've got Chaos, the most ancient fiend of all. Primordial Force. We've got the Ant Lion, King of Figaro. And then we've got Stera here, who's just the most plain-looking one of all of them. And yet also the most powerful. This youth looks a bit ghostly here. It's the oldest youth I've ever seen. Ant-Man's twin brother. Ant-Man and the Wasp. Let's go. Time for ludicrous speed. This is a very manly looking Kefka. Top luck percent incoming, Shaw. He calling it. Not a missing in percent, so. Ludicrous speed, go! Guy's calling soft luck already. You could have been calling free seed if you've seen our attack car already. Chaos riding a chocobo? How does he even fit on that chocobo? Chaos is massive. think he shrunk himself down to bottom size. Meteo. Ludicrous speed, go!
Thank you.
Did we get anything there? I don't think we got anything. Robbed game. Coin toss, that could be useful. No, not now. What the best? What the fuck? Thank you for that. Uh-oh, this could be bad. Wow. What just happened here? Yeah, this is the new version of Beyond Chaos, actually. Lots of cool stuff going on here. We got Chaos on our team. Fake mustache. Hmm. Effect there. This might turn 3x miss into R limit, which is R limit is desperation attacks, which are almost always OP in this game. Normally unique to each character and only accessible when they are at near fatal HP. This turns fight into blitz? What? Oh, wow. Okay, so yeah, we want to use that. whoever has the highest vigor. Chaos has the highest vigor, but this vigor is almost comparable, and these other stats are much better in speed and stamina. I guess we should probably give it to Chaos, because he's really not doing much of anything right now, aside from jumping. I need to use Seraphim here. Now we have a poison attack. That's cool. That's everything I can do there for now. Nice, we have our limit now. That's amazing. And we have Blitz. wow, we have fire dance already. This is the most original name for an enemy I have ever seen. Let's go. Chaos Suplex, that's amazing, let's go. Only in this game would you see a Chaos Suplex. That's a high five. Wow, look at that. That's a super high five. We can one-shot these guys? Or these men, rather? For a second, I thought this enemy's name was Volkswagen. What in the world? What does that do? Low HP shell, that's good. Thank you. D-pad is not well suited to fire that. Here's a drop there. I can respond it. Modern Agamemnon. Either that, or the Agamemnon will become sickly. Or maybe it's a Saria. Saria best Agamemnon. Argus is green like the Incredible Hulk. Take one more encounter here to heal. There it is, Ant-Man and Dewan. I love it. Doesn't get any better than that. Well, the main difference is there's no free airship. You can enable its flag. This game has a lot of more randomization to it. As you can see, some of the items are doing random things. This game plays a lot more like vanilla. It's much longer. You progress through the story as you with vanilla. Now this one gets much more difficult at the end. It gets really, really hard. Nice, we got the base gear. Let's go. That is the most ghostly looking bodybuilder I've ever seen. Yeah, World's Collide usually can finish in maybe 2-3 hours. Sometimes even sub 2 if you get a good seat. Or even sub 1 if you get an incredible seat. Beyond Chaos, you're looking at probably 15 to 20 hours, and that's if you're really going fast. Okay, what does the Wasp have? Okay, they have steel and magic. Ice, oh, okay, well, this works. Another magic user. We got a pretty good team here, we got lots of options. We're about to be split up though, so we'll see how that goes. That's where it's gonna start getting really tough. Thank you. Yadam has a question mark by it. That means it does something different than it does in vanilla. You should check it. And items are very expensive this game. Holy crap. You're gonna have to get the Edgar discount. Step regen. Okay, so this has a 10 Tenabar effect. In every step you take, you get HP back. Sadly, nobody can use it yet. That's a pretty good ability. Is that Johnny from Chrono Trigger? No. Who is that? Death protection. Nobody can use it. Find out if the item we get here is randomized based upon your decision with Banna. So we'll try the yes first. It's faster. Alright, so he gives us a Tintinabar. Wait, what is this thing? I've never seen this thing before. This is a bonus scene here. Wow, they've added scenes? Oh, that's who it is. It's the ninja dude from Naruto. Ooh, now that teaches Bolt 2. That could be really beneficial. We don't know what the other item is yet, so... I guess I take a save state here. Get from this guy. Falchion sword. That's a strong sword. So a strong sword or a relic that regens HP and teaches us Bolt 2. I think the answer is clear here. So who's going to be the best user of it? Like Atman will be. Wasp has nothing but steel right now. I guess we should probably start working on them. Bannon has some nice equipment there. Oh yeah, much more dynamic. Random enemies that are placed here and there, different abilities. Some things are vanilla, so it's pretty friendly to someone that's new to Rando. Light battle scene here. Oh snap, Bannon has sword pick. That's his name, it's Kakashi. jalapenos, I blank. Yeah, we got some spicy flags going here. The end game is going to be really difficult. We don't get to choose the party we take in there for the final boss. A lot of the stuff is completely randomized here. We did get our limit, which is going to be huge. Our limit is essentially a desperation attack. But there have been a lot of new sprites updated, music. No, not permadeath yet. I'm not ready for that yet. I need some practice first. Yeah, there's nothing worse than getting 6-7 hours into your game and then, oh, wipe from an enemy that you couldn't even prepare for. Permadeath is really just about finding an early grind spot, praying that you get something that will carry you. We have no tents. We won't need Bannon to have... Excuse me, we won't need Bannon to be unblinded for him to use his sword tech ability. That's ultimately what it comes down to. If someone likes to do it hardcore, then why not? I've done my share of hardcore challenges. I just like to have a bit of practice in it, familiarize myself more. I haven't done a Final Fantasy VI, Worlds Collide, or Beyond Chaos in a long time. I think both have removed the bugs, but you can leave in the option for Sketch. Sketch can still cause issues. So I choose to leave it out. But if you know what you're doing, you can do things like the Sketch glitch, and then you can use it for your benefit. It's a flag in Beyond Chaos. You can choose to have Sketch coupled into the list of potential skills as well. Oh, the bugs, yeah. The flag definitely says use it at your own risk. But I know there's some people who can use the sketch bug to their benefit, to glitch items or progression. I am not one of them. I haven't tried Brave New World yet. It's on my bucket list. I really like that hairband cast strap and that was done at first. Had it happen on the cart? Yeah, I've had it happen too. I've lost save files. And it's always save files that have a lot of hours on them. back in the days before emulation, I would go to GameFAQ, and I would upload my game save there from GameShark. That way, even if I lost a file on card, I knew I could always back it up to the GameShark or the GameGee. And there were times where that actually saved me. I lost my file, and I went to GameFAQ and got it back. People make fun of GameFAQ now, but it's still up, and there's still a lot of useful information there. I've got guides there. Yeah, I did have it pre-internet, too. The weird thing was, it was a newer copy. Or at least it seemed like it was. I got it from Software Etc. And I ended up taking it back. That was like when Software Etc was first starting. Stands the test of time. Good guide always does. Oh, he used to be employed by them. I heard the benefits are pretty good there, or they were. We're strong enough now. We're gonna keep going. I could do something like Triton GL and keep grinding here forever. I still got the player's guide. I was just looking at it the other day. I remember being a teenager just looking at that guide when I first got the game, like, wow. Look at this art. Look at this story. I played this game for three days straight when I first got it. My dad finally said, "You stink. Go take a shower." So it wasn't just me then. Good to know, because my family swears I was the only kid that was doing that. I was like, no, somewhere there's other kids doing this. Nice, yeah, that's commitment. Did you do Tyranno Forest? It reminds me of when I did the Secret of Mana play and I got every level 9 orb and weapon. I had that on cart for the longest time. And then I ended up having to sell the cart. Oh snap, we just got Aquarake. That's really bad. How come they haven't used Aquarake the whole time until now? Really, game? It it's a good grind. I'd always pick someone with a pally shield there, get that going. To figure out the stats thing too. Once I did though, holy crap, OP. I would keep Odin for a long time just to get the speed bonus instead of upgrading him to Raiden. This is Toxic Avenger Ultros. One of my favorite things to do in vanilla was just never teach Cayenne or Shadow any magic or lock. And then just max their stats and take them into the arena. Best thing ever is beating Siegfried. Or Chupon. But that's something I do in Beyond Chaos also. If we get a character that has high vigor and doesn't learn magic, I will purposely keep them from learning magic. Just so I can load them up for the arena. This game does need more mock. Okay, scenario time. Here we are. It's like Mog is Umaro, and their weapon is dried meat. A naked Terra has a sprite of an Imperial soldier. Mog is Umaro. And they have dried meat as their weapon. And they have soft equipped as, what is that? Their helmet? Oh, it looks like they have fight only. Okay, which scenario to do first? I usually like to do the long scenarios first. I'm glad I left Bolt 2 on this guy. Soon we will have it. Although MP is still quite low. Thank you. call you Sergeant Sledge. What you got? Mimic, hello. And throw. We got a lot of shortcuts that I grinded earlier, so this could be useful. And they can't equip the cards we just bought. Nice. Shadow stats are usually good, has a very high innate evade, and he has Interceptor. That's one of the reasons why I like Shadow so much for the arena. I never knew you were so on the FF6 bike. Have a good work clip. And once you're off, we can chat more about it, maybe. Also, yeah, we just got fried here. That's bad. Let's go back to use free bed now. Enemy side. Really? Can't run? I'm glad I ground those shurikens earlier. They're being of extreme use now. No, I don't want to go that way. Probably stop taking encounters or Shadow will run away. Another soldier? Light music here. Okay, Grant, what you got? Crystal shield, that's nice. Wow, is that Ragnarok and Tritot? If so, that's OP. A bit of magic there. That should be pretty strong now. That is Ragnarok. That's gonna be so huge early on. Holy crap. It's got a free Phoenix down. Drop Oath Veil. We'll take that if it works. Did we really just get an Oath Veil? We sure did. Holy crap. This is an advanced armor item. This character is going to do good things for us. We're taking all these encounters now. Both males might sell for quite a bit too, so this is a double win. Rage Ring, we can get different stuff? This is a jackpot. Off Thunderblade. Is it random what Ragnarok turns him into? This is Mazeballs. All kinds of good stuff here. Okay, looks like it might be limited to three different items. Phoenix Down, Thunderblade, the other item, Rage Ring. General Leo's a chicken.
What?
Now they're mocking him. I guess you're right, Z. If you provoke them, they are very dangerous, and they will swarm. Shurikens, we'll take them. crystal nail, that'd be nice. And we got crystal nail pipe. Now, can we mimic the Ragnarok? They're off that guard, let's go. This is freaking incredible. Ah, oh, but he missed it. I want that back guard. I'm not the chocobo, but. Giving it up. This guy must have a super low chance of getting the item. Finally got it. What did we get? We got the back guard. Nice. That's probably the best one. Arm bangle, oh, that'd be great. And we got it, let's go! Affects Terrado, we could use the charm bangle in battle to summon Terrado. That's incredible. Now we have an earth elemental attack. I gotta say, I'm enjoying this PC run so far. There's a lot of cool stuff going on here. Mr. Red, thank you for the contribution. I will try this. Yeah, that's Toronto, sure enough.
Wow.
What is this? Ooh, relic ring, that's tasty. Dang, we didn't get the relic ring. I want to see what that did. Normally I'd just skip and keep going, but seeing as this is beyond chaos, we kind of want to find everything. Long game. I know you want to give me a juicy relic, right? Getting so hot now. Cursed ring, ew. Okay, crystal ring, flame saber, cards. I think white dress was another one. Tristring teaches X Zone. Well, that's something. Alright, all, it's getting too hot. I've got to cut stream for a bit. We have no AC here. I need to go cool down. Thank you for watching. If I get cooled down, we might have some more games later. Send you Jupiter Climb at the raid. Good seeing y'all. I hope you're staying cool wherever you're at. Yeah, I might have to throw my head in the shower here. Let's go give Jump the hype, and we'll see you all soon. GG.